Good morning, everyone. Today is another important day in terms of the election that we bring to the yourself team. And we are able to go through a particular topic that was brought by Terry, and as it's indicated on the whiteboard that this particular election is there for people that are interested in social studies and the subject. And the topic that we are looking at is known as conservation of resources. Now, in your previous lesson, Mr. Seyi was able to explain to you about a topic known as pollution. And this is a continuation of what we are supposed to do. He was able to help you understand it. The aspect of pollution is when you and I, in other words, my activity leads towards the release of harmful substances in the air, water, and land. Okay? And the effect of that particular war is the fact that it destroys our natural environment here within ourselves. And you will agree with me that in the environment that we have the resources that we are supposed to utilize that helps us in terms of we moving on with our lifestyle. And so today we are going to look at conservation of resources. I want you to look at the word conservation. What conservation is actually talking about, okay, or what is the meaning of conservation? So conserve, it means to preserve, to protect, and to manage something, okay? And resources, it talks about anything that man can use, okay, that is useful to man. That is what we call resources. So these resources are essential to man. So therefore, if we don't conserve it, if we don't protect the resources, then there are going to be some problems that we are not able to contain. But however, let us move to the topic itself, right? In this lesson, we are supposed to look at the definition of conservation of resources. We are also going to look at the type of conservation, which I have already indicated on the board, which says land conservation, water conservation, oil conservation, and mineral conservation. Okay? Like I said, let us take a look at the definition of conservation resources. What is conservation resources? Conservation of resources. It says it's the proper management or protection of our limited available resources. Okay, for what? For future generation. For future generation. Now, the emphasis that I want us to pay attention to the aspect of we looking at the world. Proper management or protection, right? And at the same time, limited available resources. Now, conservation of resources, like I stated, it talks about proper management or protection of our limited available resources. So, manage our resources. So, conserve our resources in the first place. We really need to work to manage it properly. Because it is only when we are able to manage resources then we'll be able to utilize it at the same time to protect it, for it not to become extinct. Right? Here are people that are going to come out at our have a privilege to enjoy these abilities. Now, protection goes to the aspect of management, right? It gives you that aspect of security, right? It prevents the resources from being utilized or being misused, whereas you use the resources in the wrong way that you're not supposed to use it, right? Or in the instance whereas you have some amount of resources, instead of using it rationally, you decide to use it in the form of wasting, right, or destroying it. Okay? We talk about limited available resources. There is no part in the world where resources are considered to be unlimited in terms of itself, right? Resources that we are exposed to are limited in original sense. Because why? These limited resources are the ones that we're supposed to protect, right? Because we need them. And because they are not sufficient, and at the same time the demand in terms of utilization is great, and at the same time, what we are supposed to do? We really need to protect these resources so that those that will be coming after us, like I've stated in our future generation, will not have a problem of finding a way around and have access to the resources and the I will make reference to what Sam Chazari was talking about in his observation, right? That the manner in which man is multiplying in terms of number, right? The demand will also increase in terms of the need for these limited resources. And as a result, we'll have to engage ourselves in some good ways. And for us also to engage ourselves in this particular aspect, which Charles Darwin made mention of, we really need to also properly manage our resources. Okay? And the next point that we also need to look at is type of conservation. Okay? Type of conservation is basically looking at the different forms of conservation, the resources that have been conserved. Okay? Now, we have the first one, which is known as land conservation. The second one is water conservation. And the next one is forest conservation. And the fourth one is mineral conservation. Okay? All of these are essential materials that we need. Okay? You and I, we cannot go without land. Okay? It's not only essential to man, but also other organisms. Water is also an essential source in terms of the existence of plant and other living organisms. We talk about forest. We need these forests in our environment. Okay? The reason being, it serves as a resource for man, and at the same time, it serves as food for other inhabitants. Okay? Minerals. You and I, there are different types of minerals which we are exposed to, right? These minerals are not created by man, they are given to us by God. So, because these minerals are so precious that we always want them every day, okay? But if we continue to exploit these minerals, there will be a particular time that we will not be able to have access to these minerals. Therefore, minerals is considered to be one of the resources that we are supposed to work. Now let us take a look at the four types of conservation that we're supposed to discuss this morning. Because for this lesson, we are going to concentrate on land conservation. Okay? Have a look at the definition of conservation of resources. And at the same time, I have given you the aspects of the different types of conservation. I want us to concentrate on what we refer to as land conservation. Okay? This is where I want to continue. Alright. Now, what do we refer to as land conservation? Land conservation simply means the management, the protection, of the land for the utilization of man. Okay? In other words, the existence of land is important to terrestrial or land life that exists for it. Okay? So, the soil helps us in terms of getting some of our basic needs. What do we refer to as some of these basic needs? We talk about food, right? We talk about shelter, we talk about clothing. All of these things, we get them from where? From the land. Okay? So therefore, if we engage ourselves in destroying the land, what will definitely happen? We will not be able to enjoy these basic needs. We will not be able to get these basic needs that we always want. Okay? Every day, man needs food. Man needs food. Food. You and I, we need shelter. We need clothing. Okay? So the only way we'll be able to continue to enjoy these facilities or these needs is for us to work. So conserve the land. Okay? The earth resources. In other words, land conservation can also be referred to as the protection of the earth resources. Right? The protection of the earth resources. Okay? The earth resources. Now, what we want to ask, Mr. Bangwa, please help us with some examples for the earth resources. I'll just mention some of them. You talk about food, right? You talk about water. Okay? You talk about the aspect of shelter. Right? You talk about falling. All of these items are what we refer to as earth resources. There are many, okay? For your own understanding, I've been able to give you some aspects of earth resources that you may be using. Okay? Now, let us come back to what we are looking at in terms of the conservation of the land. Having stated that conservation of the land refers to the protection of the land as resources in order for us to be able to utilize it rationally or for the benefit of man, okay, and also for protecting for the future generation. Now, in terms of land conservation, there are different methods that we normally use in terms of protecting or conserving or managing these land resources, right? Some of the methods that we use are methods which some of you are familiar with, especially those that are often agricultural science. We talk about what? Shelter belt, okay? Mulching, planting, leaf cropping, crop rotation, irrigation, okay? I go by it once more. We say method of conservation, that is method of land conservation, right? Method of land conservation. So what do we refer to as methods of land conservation? Let me take it back to that point, right? We talk about the processes or the procedures or the mechanism which we use in terms of conserving or protecting the resources, the land resources, or the resources that we get from planet Earth. Okay? I've mentioned some of them on this part, right? These resources, for us to continue to utilize these resources, there are ways of how we can protect them in terms of land conservation. And I've mentioned the aspect of shelter belts. Right? Mulching, terracing, seed cropping, crop rotation, and irrigation. Now let us try to see how best to be able to have a clear understanding of these different methods that we have mentioned here. Right? The first one is saying shelter belt. What is shelter belt? Shelter belt simply talks about what? It involves the planting of trees within a piece of land in order to create a source of wind. Okay? It says, Jezebel. It involves the planting of seed on a piece of land, on a piece of land to break the force of the wind. Now, it serves as a protection, right? Whereas when you experience what heavy wind within a particular area, and for us to be able to control this wind, we need to plant trees within that particular land so that at the end of the day, our houses or whatever resources that we have developed within that particular period will not be destroyed by the force of the wind. Okay? Many of us have heard about typhoon, right? Where are some areas where the wind destroys certain places. Okay? So in order for us to control, right, to serve as a blanket, in other words, to resist, just like what we are trying to get body in what they have, right? We say the atmosphere comes as well as a blanket, right? That depends on the high penetration of the sun rays, right? So that is exactly what the shelter does in terms of protecting the land. Okay? Another point that we also need to look at is mulching. Right? What do we refer to as mulching? Mulching is the covering of the soil, right? Which enables it to have what? A better condition. Okay? Proper condition in of the soil. Okay? You cover the soil with what? With plants or plant leaves. Okay? Which enables the plant to be the soil to be in a very good condition. Right? And next a method that is also being used in terms of looking at methods that can conserve the land resources is known as fencing, right? This involves the aspect of you cutting the land into different levels, right? In order for you to allow an organized flow of water. Okay? You cut the land into different levels, whereas it will allow you to have an organized flow of and water. Okay? Another point that we also need to look at, which is also another method that is being used, is known as drip cropping. Okay? Now, what is drip cropping? Drip cropping is where you alternate crops, that is closely related crops, right, with ones that do not occupy water. Okay? So that at the end of the day, you have a great increase on the land. Right? So that is exactly what we refer to as drip cropping. In terms of alternating what? Close growing crops. And you will engage that particular land crops that do not occupy much space in terms of the ground. Another point that we also need to look at, it is known as what? Crop rotation. Right? We talk about rotation. Rotation talks about the movement of the crop, right? In agricultural science and also in social studies, we are encouraged not to engage in monocultural method of farming, right? In other words, monoculture talks about the cultivation of one particular crop on a piece of land. According to some people that have done some research on this work, it says, if you continue to plant a particular crop on a particular piece of land, what happens is that the soil nutrients will definitely diminish. In other words, it will destroy. So what most people do is for them to rotate a crop, right? So you are encouraged to engage in what? Leaf cultivation, right? Which going to be in a very good condition. Okay? Another point that we also need to look at, which is a method that is in use, is known as what? Irrigation. Irrigation is a process of you transferring water or you extracting or you extract water from an area where as you can get water to an area where as there is little water. Right? If you remember when we are looking at the ecosystem, one of the types of ecosystem, which is the desert ecosystem, right? This is a mechanism or a method that is widely used in that particular area in the desert ecosystem, right? Irrigation. Because majority of the land within the desert ecosystem do not have sufficient or no water. So, we are also made from the plan that the area that you can get limited source of water or noise is within the oasis, right? So what people have done within those areas is for them to engage themselves in irrigation. We are at the top water from an area where there is plenty of water and it can buy it to where? To an area where they have little or no water. Okay? Now, like I said, our concentration on this particular lesson is for us to look at what? The definition of conservation of resources, and at the same time, for us to understand the different types of resources conservation. And we are also looking at what? One of the types of conservation, okay? Which is what? Land conservation. Right? And I have explained to you that land conservation talks about what? The protection of preservation of the earth resources. Right? So at the end of the day, I've been able to help you to understand that what? In conserving the land resources, we have different methods which we engage ourselves in. Okay? I've gone through all of these methods, which are what? Shelter belts, mulching, salinity, peak cropping, crop rotation, and irrigation. Okay? What I want you guys to do for me is that I want to encourage you guys to read on the remaining ones, which are water conservation, forest conservation, and mineral conservation. Okay? I think I saw light on all of these ones. Okay? Now we are talking about what? Global warming. Shortage of what? Water, right? And also the forest is being depleted, okay? Because according to some research, it is stated that 50% of the earth was covered with forest, okay? So what is now happening with this particular resource that we are supposed to enjoy, okay? We talk about minerals. Every day we are exposed to the aspect of what? Pollution. There are people who have to go into extract those minerals, right? I may want to pause on this particular note and for me to see whether if you guys have any questions. And if there are no questions, I may want to give you a follow-up reading work that you need to do as we progress with this particular lesson. So I'll wait and see whether if you have any questions or suggestions. If there are no questions, then I want us to look at an assignment. Please ensure that you do this for me. Please. Now we have looked at the definition type. I want you to give me six reasons for conserving our resources. Okay? conserving our resources.
I want you to take 6 reasons why we should conserve our resources. Right? I've told you about the need and the meaning of conservation of resources. So I hope that you guys will be able to look at it, and I will definitely call it to experience.